Thank you for joining us. We begin tonight with a historic settlement. It is the largest of its kind ever in our state.
It's being paid to a Scott County jail inmate for alleged neglect that he says almost led to his death. John Croman joins us now with our top story. John?
Well, when Terrance Winborn arrived at the hospital, he was already in multiple organ failure and would later need double amputations. But his attorneys discovered the Scott County jail staff waited more than 24 hours after he first started showing symptoms of serious illness to drive him to an ER.
Every time I dream, I hear my hands, you know. Then I wake up, they're gone again.
Terrance Winborn, in a video clip from the Robbins Kaplan Law Firm, showing how he's dealing with the loss of his arms. It was played for reporters at a news conference announcing a $12 million settlement against Scott County for delays getting Winborn medical help he needed as an inmate in the county jail.
That deliberate indifference allowed a bacterial infection to run rampant within his body, leading to a heart attack, purpuric lesions, septic shock, gangrene, a bilateral transradial amputation, and a host of other devastating and permanent injuries.
Winborn was booked into the Scott County Jail August 27th, 2020, for driving while intoxicated. He began throwing up the first day and couldn't walk or talk by the second day.
Nurse Schneider noted Mr. Winborn had been rapidly declining. His blood pressure was at a strokeout level. He was in lots of pain.
He'd spend the next 122 days hospitalized, racking up $2 million in medical bills that Scott County would not pay.
You know, it's something would nobody want to go through. And I really can't explain it because it's been so many times I thought I'd been passed away.
The jail failed to notify the State Department of Corrections until 2 years later, and by then all of the surveillance video had been deleted.
Which under state law, the jails are required to report a serious incident within 10 days. And generally, as a part of that process, the Department of Corrections will request video.
Now, Scott County and the insurer, the Minnesota County's Intergovernmental Trust, agreed to this settlement yesterday. They said today, and I quote, "We are hopeful the resolution of this matter will help provide Mr. Winborn with medical care and quality of life assistance he needs." Back to you. Wow.